Good morning and welcome to our Monday morning Time and Word devotional. I'm Pastor Will, and it's great having you with us here today. I'd like to begin our time together here this Monday morning by reading to you from 1 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 4. Hear the word of the Lord. I urge then, first of all, that petitions, prayers, and thanksgiving be made for all people, for kings and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. This is good and pleases God our Savior, who wants all people to be saved and come to a knowledge of the truth. May the Lord bless the reading of his holy word. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for your word this morning. Now pray, Lord, your blessings upon us as we come before it. Open our eyes to the truth you would have us to learn here this Monday morning. We do pray this in your name. Amen. If you remember, this past Friday, we discussed the importance of praying for revival. This morning, the day before the elections, I want us to focus again on prayer. You know, I can't think of a better time to address the topic of prayer, and with that, a greater need for prayer than at this present moment. In many ways, prayer is God's key given to us to unlock his power upon this earth. If we will but only use it, there's no telling what God can do through it, that is, through our prayers. In connection with the elections, the impact of prayer can be ultimately for the good of all. Here in the opening passage that I just read to you, we find the Apostle Paul exhorting his readers to pray. To pray, as he says, for kings and all those in authority. To pray that God would grant them the wisdom needed to govern in a way that is both right and good. To pray that each elected official would seek to do what is right, rather than merely do what is politically expedient. And with that, to pray for their protection. To pray, really, for all our elected officials, even if we might not always agree with their views or with their politics. Remember, when Paul wrote these words, Nero was Caesar. Certainly no friend to the Christians. But Paul exhorted his readers to pray for him anyhow. And with this, we would do well to pray for all to live, as Paul says, peaceful and quiet lives, lives of godliness and holiness. Lives filled with compassion for all of our neighbors, regardless of how one may vote. Seeking to shine the light of Christ in a world filled with such rancor and division. You know, the change that prayer can bring about is greater than any change than any election can deliver. So by all means, my friends, let us pray. Pray for wisdom to vote according to God's will. Pray for all who will be elected, regardless if we voted for them or not. And pray. Pray for peace to descend upon this land. And all the while praying for God's compassion to fill our hearts. And as you pray, my friends, take a moment take a moment to praise God. To praise Him that no matter how any election turns out, God is still upon His throne. God is still in control. Well, that's about it from here this Monday morning. May God richly bless each and every one of you. Blessings to all. Till next time on Time and a Word, have a great day.